Well, shall we recap that? The president just can't resist a question from any and all reporters. Moments ago, if you were watching, he covered Venezuela, he covered North Korea, and he covered Kavanaugh. I need help to cover this. Peter Brookes is with us, senior national security fellow at the Heritage Foundation. First of all, Peter, the news seems to be that President Trump is going to meet again, and he says, in the very near future, with Kim Jong-un of North Korea. That, to me, was the news from that impromptu press conference.
Yeah, I should think you should take the president at his word on this. We just don't know where and when, and that's what staff are working out. Probably be another neutral site. It would be extraordinary if Kim were to travel to the United States. Of course, there is talk that he may actually travel to Seoul for another meeting between North and South in the coming months or weeks. But we'll have to see where it's going to be and when it's going to be and what the agenda is going to be.
But
I think a lot of it
forward.
Has to do with relationship building.
But the thing is, it has moved forward. It's not a static situation with North Korea. I mean, our president just moved this forward. And then he talked, talked about Venezuela right from the start of that little impromptu press conference there, talked about the suffering of the Venezuelan people. And I think he said, I'll meet anyone, anytime, to save one life. Does that mean to you that maybe he'll meet the Venezuelan delegation at the UN?
It's certainly a possibility, but, you know, his staff is going to want to make sure there's something they can accomplish. You know, this is self-inflicted. This economic situation in Venezuela is self-inflicted, unfortunately. Venezuela doesn't have to be like this, especially an oil-rich country such as Venezuela is, and a country that has a long tradition prior to recent regimes of democracy. So I think the president is, you know, this is in the Western Hemisphere. This is a neighbor of ours. He met yesterday with the president of Colombia. He's concerned about what effects it has on the region and on our partners in Colombia. So I think the president will do what he needs to do. And if there's an opportunity that his staff can arrange for him to advance, you know, the interests of the United States and of those of the Venezuelan people, I think he'll take that meeting.
All right, Peter, out of time, but thanks very much for joining us at a very opportune moment.
Me.
Got it. Thanks. Quickly?
Quickly, the president said on the sidelines at the UN yesterday that the military could easily topple the Maduro regime if the military decided to do that. They also, the Trump White House, imposed fresh new sanctions on Venezuela, including on Maduro's wife.
And he also just said all options vis-a-vis Venezuela
are on the
table. But
he also said he's willing to meet with Maduro himself, and then added after that, but every option is still on the table.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, a lot
there. Active day, is it not? We love that.